This is the BTR11 and it's the most awaited product this year. So let's find out what all the hype is about. Now, before we talk about the FiiO BTR11 itself, I want to show you guys something. This is the Asselin Kern XP10, and this has been the hottest selling product for the year 2023. We literally sold thousands upon thousands of units, and I personally own one, and I've been using it for the last 2 years every single day. Now, there are many reasons to love this product. You see, it's compact, it's convenient, and the sound quality is just superb from Asselin Kern. But it's not perfect. Some of the things that people don't like, including me, are the older Bluetooth 4.1 version, the micro USB, and the worst of all, the battery life. Lately, I wasn't able to get more than 3 hours of playback on this DAC. But in spite of all of these troubles, you'll find that till today, people swear by the Asselin Kern XP10. But why? You see, while we have wired portable DACs which give you the best high-res lossless playback and they're pretty reliable as well, they're simply not convenient. If you happen to be traveling a lot like me, you'll find that having a wired DAC can often be an issue. That's because the phone is always physically connected to the DAC and you can't really use your phone independently. Plus, if you're traveling in crowded areas and you're constantly being pushed and the chances where that you can inflict some damage, you'll find that there are multiple places where this damage can affect. You can either end up damaging the port on your phone or damaging the cables on your DAC and IEM, which is never good. So when the FiiO BTR11 was launched, like you, I was super excited. Now this thing is just for ₹1999. So for that, you'll find that the packaging is pretty simple. You get right to it. You have the BTR11 when you unbox it. You have a C2A charging cable and some paperwork on how to actually use the DAC. Now compared to the XP10, I found that this thing was practically weightless. It's got this rectangular design this time around. And as I mentioned, it's super lightweight. And even though it's made out of an all plastic build, you'll find that it's good to see that FiiO went the extra mile and add some texture and patterns on this. It looks a little bit more interesting and doesn't feel like an absolute toy. Now, having said that, at the back you have this clip over here which is attached to the DAC itself, which is very, very convenient. I tend to use my Bluetooth DAC on my runs, and the XP10 had a separate clip on it, so if you lost the clip then it's difficult to carry it along with it, but with the FiiO BTR11 that's not going to happen. So with the clip at the back, you can use it on your shirt, on your belt, wherever you want to attach it on your clothes, and you can have the DAC with you securely without worrying about it falling down. Now you have three physical buttons on the DAC itself. There are two volume controls for volume up and down, but if you long press them, you can go to the previous track or skip tracks in general. And you also have a single multifunction button. Now this can act as a pairing button and it can act as a play pause button. And if you get calls on this, you can also pick and drop calls. That's right. This also has a microphone and a 3.5 jack. We'll get to more on that later. Now, the FiiO BTR11 ships with Bluetooth 5.3, which is a major upgrade from the XP10. Additionally, you also have support for SBC, AAC, and LDAC codecs. So that means that you can actually stream high-res lossless audio up to 96 kHz wirelessly, provided that you have an Android phone that also supports LDAC. For me, I was personally using it along with Apple Music and my iPhone, so it was basically shuffling between SBC and AAC, and I found that the connection was pretty stable. Even in more crowded places like a metro or a train ride, you'll find that it kept out with the connections without any flickers, which was pretty impressive because with XP10 and even some high-end wireless earbuds, connection seems to break off whenever there's a lot of crowd. Now, talking about conveniences and connections, the FiiO BTR11 supports multipoint. What this means is that you can have two devices connected to the BTR11 at once. Now, I tried it out with two iOS devices and two Android devices, and they switched seamlessly. However, when using an iOS and an Android device, the connection was a bit glitchy. It works sometimes, sometimes it doesn't. Sometimes altogether, you just have to reset the BTR11 to get a proper connection. It's a little glitchy at the moment, and I think FiiO can fix this with a small firmware update in the future. Now, under the hood, the FiiO BTR11 is using a BSC2700IHC audio chip. Now, this is quite a respectable chip. You'll also find it in some of the higher end Bluetooth earbuds. It's responsible for the audio as well as the stability in terms of connection. For me, I found the sound signature to be slightly on the warmer side, but overall, it's still very well balanced. And in terms of usability, I tried it out with the Tangzhu Warner, the Salnode Zero and a bunch of IEMs around the 2K mark, and it did a very good job pairing with most of them. Both in terms of sound signature and overall drivability, it's quite respectable what the BTR11 can do. Now, I did find that when pairing with IEMs like the KZ or ultra-sensitive IEMs like say something like Campfire on the extreme end, it does tend to have this background hiss when you're not playing music. But in my personal experience, as soon as you play music on your phone or any other device, the hiss kind of disappears and then soon comes after when you have paused the music. So it's not as big of a deal for me, and especially considering the price of just 1999, I think it's pretty forgivable in my opinion. Now, when it comes to battery life, this was the biggest boost from something like the XB10 that we were using, right? So XB10 claimed around 5 hours, but in realistic use, 2.5-3 hours is what you can actually get. With the FiiO BTR11, you get 15 hours of playback. Now, the 15 hours of playback is as long as you're using the SBC and AAC codec. So if you're using iOS devices, since they don't have haptics HD and LDAC codec support, you'll find that you'll get close to 14 to 15 hours, like in my case with my iPhone 16. But if you're using Android devices, I was getting close to around the 7 to 8 hour battery life on a single charge, which again is quite a lot than what you were getting on the XP10. And even in general, if you look at the wireless market right now, it's on the higher side of the average, which is always good. So when you're using this DAC while you're traveling or commuting or any of these things, you'll find that on a single charge, you'll at least have a couple of days use before you have to charge it again and again. Now, coming to things that I wasn't too pleased about, the FiiO BTR11 and its microphone quality. Now, the FiiO BTR11 features an inbuilt mic on the DAC itself. That means you can practically take calls regardless of your IEM having an inline mic or not. However, the quality of the microphone for me was pretty subpar. You see, it tends to pick up a lot of background noise, and ultimately your voice as the caller is pretty muffled on the other side of the line. So if you're someone who tends to take a lot of calls, I would say skip taking calls on the BTR11. You're much better taking calls on your cell phone. Another thing with the DAC is that you cannot use it in a wired mode. A lot of the other DACs in the FiiO lineup, like the BTR13 and the BTR17, you can use them both as wireless and wired DACs for true high-res lossless playback. But this is primarily an issue on the BTR11 because it's using the BSC2700 chip, which is mainly a Bluetooth audio chip and cannot do wired decoding. And I think for the price tag, it's forgivable, but it would have been a nice cherry on the top. But in conclusion, I think the FiiO BTR11 still gives you a great product for the price that you pay. Right now in the market, there's literally nothing at that price point which gives you the compatibility, the reliability when it comes to battery life, and the sound quality what the FiiO BTR11 offers. I have in front of me some of the good high-end wireless earbuds that you can get in the market right now. I have the XM5 and the AirPods over here. And while they offer some great features like the app equalizers and the ease of pairing the AirPods with an iOS ecosystem, when it comes to sound quality, the BTR11 along with a good IEM under 2000 rupees like a Tangzu and a KZ or even the Salnode Zero is just simply unbeatable, even for something like the Sony and the AirPods. So that's going to do it for my review on the FiiO BTR11. Do let me know your thoughts about the BTR11, or if you have any questions, drop them below in the comment section. If you want to try it out in person, you're most welcome to come here in our experience studio in Mumbai, or catch us at one of our several Headphone Connect events happening in a city near you. But that's going to do it for now. I'll see you guys in the next one. Until then, happy listening.